Being able to get to things in an arm's reach is amazing. Never been able to do that before with other consoles or control surfaces. And I was very impressed with how quickly I got rolling. You know, the first time I ever sat and did a mix was, you know, almost instantaneous. It's really easy to get what the director wants. I mean, when we had another console in here, you're sort of stuck over there where the screens were a lot of the time, and the faders were just sort of like a big mouse tacked on that you wouldn't really touch. You do a lot of it clicking over here. Now, it's not only eyes being brought back over to a control surface, it's also your whole body, your monitoring positions back in the middle of the room.
The way it's designed, everything is giving you a quick overview and you can quickly scroll through your faders and see what's going on. Just allows you to get back to actually doing your job instead of trying to find where stuff is. Yeah, there's definitely a lot more mixing going on instead of trying to find tracks, etc., and also stopping, flipping layers, working out what I'm going to do next. You're working that out as you're doing it.
Yeah.
As you're rolling code, so you're constantly just mixing. You're constantly going through the motions instead of thinking about it.
I EQ in here. I want to do a couple of EQs. Now, I want to copy that, so I hold it down, I double press, and then I just touch the channels on the arc that I want them to go to, so these ones, and you can see it paste in. It's as simple as that.
So pretty much there's just less stopping in between now, so you basically have the time to be putting in to actually mixing instead of setting stuff up, etc.
Oh, but you might be working on some dialogue, and the director goes, oh, can we pull the music back, you know, coming up, and you're like, usually you would go, okay, well, I'll just finish what I'm doing here. But now I can just go, oh, music, I'll just go over to the music tracks, so I'll just pull them back, you know. So now, not only is it me who can remember things coming up, but now the director will get things quicker, you know, which is sometimes frustrates them, that they'll say something and you're like, okay, we'll get to that. But now you can instantly get to things and makes you look better to the client because, you know, you're a superstar. You know, you can get to things really quickly and be almost second-guessing.
90 tracks and where's that annoying bird or whatever it is, you can just quickly find it, grab it, shut it up straight away. That's right. I'll deal with that later. Away you go. You pretty much go, I wish I could do that, and then you discover it can.
Yeah, that's right. But here, he'll say, I want the first word from track one. You go, okay, yeah, I'll put track one in there. Go track one, then track five, then track nine, then track 13. So I've got all four of those tracks here, and now when we go for a playback of that line, I'll go, well, that word was from there, that word's from there, that word's from there, and that word's from there. You know, being able to instantly playback without having to touch any editing, you know, over here on the Pro Tools. The actor might say, oh, you know, my mic's a bit loud, you can just touch the microphone input. And you can see it's labelled here as, you know, you'd have headphone send, and it would be labelled here, and you could see exactly how much he's getting, and you can just hit a button and pull it back. Another thing is being able to talk back, not only to just the actor, but you've got three different bus sends that you can send to, say, just the cans, you could send to the DAT machine slate, you know, down the ISDN line. So you can send your talkback microphone to a combination of different places. So you can just say to the actor, I know, they're being a pain in the ass. Or you can say to them, oh, yeah, this actor's not very good, and not have to have the mic open to everyone, so it gives you more flexibility with communication in an ADR session where usually you only maybe have one or two options on an older solution.
At a snapshot, being able to, at a glance, being able to quickly see what's in each mode, so I can quickly see those are my faders in touch mode, these are in right, so I know if I'm about to roll into anything I shouldn't. Just by holding on the parameter you want and touching the faders, so now they're all panned left instead of going through on the console and panning everything left or right, etc. You're just touching. That's one of the things that just astounds me, is that the speed of just being able to touch everything and you're ready to roll.
The monitoring section is very intuitive in that you have your sources. You can have multiple stems. You can be listening to everything at once, or you can just listen to, if you have set up in your engine, different stems, so you can listen to just the dialogue, just the music, just the effects. Having your dim button, which also your dim level is the dim button, or television as well. You always want to be pulling it up and down to a level on, say, a television in a loud living room. You just pull your monitoring back and just have a listen, you know, with the door open or something, just to make sure that you can still hear everything in the mix okay. And being able to change what speaker sets you're on as well. You can have big, medium and small. So here we've got 5.1 large speakers, then we've got medium, we could have the stereo blue skies, and then you hit small and you could have the sound coming out the television. It's all instantly one hit, and you can change all your different mix downs and monitoring just by one press of a button. It's fantastic. Instead of having to mix down through some sort of external console or routing system, it's all inside, which is fantastic.
You're not locked into anything. That's what is so flexible about it, that you can always change anything at any particular time. It has been a bit strange going back to some of the
consoles,
other surfaces, and you're automatically reaching for stuff and going, oh, but I want this in front of me, I want to change stuff, and just feeling
you've got to work with layers again.
You've got to work with layers, and you're flipping through stuff, so you're not thinking about mixing, you're thinking about how you're going to get around something and how you're going to do something, instead of actually being able to, you can just keep your mind on the job the whole time, and it's almost in the background, your arms are doing the work and bringing stuff up, and you're always thinking about the job, you're always thinking about what you're going to do next instead of setting up to do what you're going to do next. That's basically where the speed's coming from.
You're not having to work around the machine works around you.
Yeah, exactly. The machine is like, it is part of you, and you're working together. I'm just worried I said flexible and fantastic too many times. Cut it together. Flexible.
The F words, fast, flexible, fantastic.
Ergonomic spread.